Right, in the winter of 1796, Robert Burns wrote this poem. It's probably his best known work, Tam O'Shanter. He was living in 6 miles north of Dumfries at Ellisland Farm in these days. And somebody said to me one day, it's the best day's work. He wrote it in a day. It's the best day's work that a Scotsman has ever done since Bannockburn. Well, that was probably true up to the 18th of September there when Alex Salmon got a hold of him off. But anyway, I'll just start just now. When Chapman Billy's lee the street and roofy neighbours meet, as market days are wearing late and folk begin to take the gate, while we sit boozing, eating happy, getting food and unca happy, we think they know in the long Scots miles, the mosses, water, slaps and stiles that lie between us and our hames, for such our sully, sulking dame, gathering our brews like a gathering storm, nursing her wrath to keep it warm. This truth for an honest Tam O'Shanter is he for air, all night did canter, all there, for near a tune surpasses, for honest men and bonny lasses. Ah, Tam, if thou had but been so wise and taken your ain wife Kate's advice, she'd tell thee well thou wast a skellum, a blithering, blustering, drunken bellum, that frae November, day October, eh, market day, thou wast the sober, and aike am either way the mother, thou sat as long as thou had siller, that every nag was cad a shoe on, the smith and thee got roaring foo on, and at the Lord's house, even on a Sunday, thou drank the cup to gin to Monday. She prophesied that thou would be found deep drooned and doon, or catched wi warlocks in the murk by Alloway's old haunted kirk. Ah, gentle dame, said gars me greet, to think of many counsel sweet, how mony length and sage advices the husband through the wife despises. But to her tae lay merk at night, time I get planted unca right, fast by an ingle blazing finely, with reaming swats that drank divinely. And that is Elba, Souter Johnny, his ancient, trusty, truthy crony. Tam looed him like a very brother. We had been through for weeks together, the night they won me songs of clatter, and aye, the ale was getting better. The landlady and Tam grew gracious with favours, secret, sweet and precious. The suitor told his queerest stories, the landlord's laugh was ready chorus. The storm without might rear and rustle, but Tam didn't mind the storm a whistle. Care mad to see a man so happy, even drowned himself among the nappy. His bees flew home with loads of treasure, the minutes winged their way with pleasure. Kings may be blessed, but Tam was glorious, o'er all the ills of life victorious. But pleasures are like poppy spread. You see the bloom, the flower is shed, or like a snowfall on a river, a moment white then melts forever, or like the Borealis race that flit ere you can point its place, or like the rainbow's lovely form evanishing amid the storm. Nae man can tether time nor tide, the hour approaches Tam Man Ride, that hour when night's black arch to Keystay, that dreary hour he mounts his beast in, and sick a night he takes a road in, as near poor sinner was abroad in. The wind blew as 'twould blown its last, the rattling showers was on the blast, the speedy gleams of darkness swallowed, loud, deep and lang the thunder bellowed. That night a child may understand, the deil had business on his hands. Well mounted on his grey mare Meg, a better never lifted leg, Tam scalped behind through Dublin mire, despising wind and rain and fire, whilst holding fast his good blue bonnet, whilst crooning o'er some old Scots sonnet, whilst glowering round with prudent cares, lest bowl scratch one of theirs. Kirkallow all was drying nigh, where gasts and hoolets nightly cry. By this time he was across the ford, where in the snow the chapman's moored, and past the birks of meekle stane, where drunken chair the spread neck bane, and through the vins and by the cairn, where Mungo's mother hanged herself before him. Then pours all his floods. The doubling storms roll through the woods. The lightning splashed from pole to pole, near and more near the thunder's roar. When glimmering through the groaning trees, Carcala below was in a blaze. Through Elcabore the beams are glancing, and loud resounded mirth and dancing. Inspiring bold John Barleycorn, with dangers thou can make a scorn. With Tittany will fear the evil, with Uskabe will face the evil. The swat serene the Tammy's noddle, fair play he cried, he feels a boodle. But Maggie stood right sair astonished, till by heel and hand admonished, she ventured forward on a light. And wow, Tam saw an ugly sight. Warlocks and witches in a dance, they could tell you but new three fans, but hard picks, chicks through space and reels, but life and metal in their heels. A one-up bunker in the east, there's that old nick and shape of beast, a towsy dyke, black, grim and large. To give them music was his charge. He screwed the pipes and gattle skirl. The roof and rafters did a dirl. Coffins stood round like open presses that showed the deed in their last dresses. And by some devilish claptrap's light, each in its cold hand held a light, by which heroic Tam was able to note upon the haly table a murderer's banes and gibbet urns. Twa span live young Chris and Bairns, a thief, you cutted frae the rape, with his last gasp, his gab to gape. Five tomahawks with blood red rusted, five scimitars with murder crusted, a garter, a babe had strangled, a knife a feather straw had mangled, whom his ain son of life bereft, yet the grey hair stacked to the heft, with mair o' horrible an offer. Even to name would be unlawful. As Tammy glowered, amazed and furious, the mirth and fun grew fast and furious, the piper loud and louder blew, the dancers quick and quicker flew, the reel to set and roasty clicker, to like a carlin, swat and a reeker, and cursed up the knees to the walk, and Linket ate her in her sark. Now Tam, had they been quines, all broad and strapping in their teens? Their sarks, instead of creasy flannin, had been snow white 1700 linen. Their breeks of mine, my ainly pair, it ains for plush a good blue hair. I'd have gained them half my hearties, for a blink o' the bonny birdies. But whether bedlam's old and droll, or ring woody hags would spin a foal, with loupin' and flinging on a crummock, I wonder, didn't they turn my stomach? But Tam kent what was fit fu' brawly. There was a winsome wench in Wally that night enlisted on the core long after Ken and Carrick shore. For mony a beastie dead she shot, and perished mony a bony boat, and shook with meikle corn and bear, and kept the countryside in fair. Her cutty sark a paisley harm, that while a lass she had worn, though in longitude was sorely scanty, it was her best and she was vaunty. Ah, little ken thy reverend granny, that sap she coofed for her wee nanny. With 2 pound Scots, 'twas all her riches, would ever grace a dance of witches. But hear my muse, her wingman cower, sick flights afar beyond her power, to sing how nanny lapping flying a supple jade she was in strine, and how Tam stood like ain bewitched, and thought his very Eden rich. Even say, cloured and pinched with pain and hoaxed to blue with might and main. Till first a caper, sin another, Tam tint his reasons o' the giller, and roars out, "Well done, cutty sark!" And in an instance, all was dark. And scarcely had he Maggie rallied, when out the hellish legion sallied, as beast buzz out with angry fight and plundering herds assail her bite, as open pussies mortal foes, when pop she starts before her nose. As eager runs the market crowd, when catch the thief resounds aloud. So Maggie runs, the witches follow, with mony an eldritch screeching hollow. Ah Tam, they'll get thy fern. In hell they'll roast ye like a hern, in vain thy Kate awaits thy coming, Kate soon will be a woeful woman. So do thy speedy utmost beg, and when the geese stay door the brig, there at them thou thy tail may toss, a running stream they darnae cross. But ere the geese stayed she could make the faint the tail she had to shake. But Nanny, far before the rest, flew at Tam with furious ettle. But little wished she Maggie's mettle, a spring brought eft her mester hail, but left behind her angry tail. A carling caught her by the rump, and left poor Maggie scarce as stump. Now why shall we this tale of truth, let man or mother sons take heed, whene'er to drink ye are inclined, or gutty sarks run in your mind, think ye may buy the joys o'er dear, remember Tam o' Shanter's mere.